Hello and welcome to Campus Check-In, as we are now officially in March Madness mode as conference tournament season is just starting to reach the end and we're just a few days away from Selection Sunday. So let's get right to this week's syllabus. We'll preview Illinois' first game of the Big Ten Tournament as they prepare for the Big Dance. Loyola's already locked up their bid last weekend in Arch Madness. We'll hear from the Ramblers and check in with a few other men's and women's teams who are in the hunt for the Big Dance. Triton College is headed to the Hutch, and that's a first for the program in junior college. We'll tell you about that as well. But first, we begin with the Illini.
To win games and championships, you know, your culture has to be, you know, set. And I thought, you know, it wasn't set yet. You know, we were still rebuilding and trying to figure, you know, things out. But, you know, as time went on, you know, we continue to get, you know, culture guys, better players, and, you know, just guys that bought into what Coach Underwood wanted. So I think, you know, just sticking with it, you know, through the ups and downs, made it, you know, worth it.
Indeed, Trent Frazier's faith in the program paid off on Sunday when Illinois clinched a share of their first Big Ten regular season title since 2005 on Sunday with a win over Iowa. Now Brad Underwood's team eyes a repeat. That would be in the Big Ten Tournament, where they start on Friday as the defending champions in Indianapolis, doing so as the number one seed. They'll face Indiana for an early 10:30 a.m. tip-off Central Time at Gainbridge Fieldhouse. Illinois is slated for a fourth seed in many bracketology projections at the moment, but they could move up to three with a few wins in Indy. With a victory over the Hoosiers, the Illini would either face fourth-seeded Rutgers or the fifth-seeded Iowa Hawkeyes. So what is the mindset for Kofi Coburn as Illinois goes for a repeat title and looks ahead to the Big Dance?
Well, it's just the consistency part of it. You know, like you said, we just went through a long season. You know, we won the regular season, obviously. Like right now, it's just about like building, keeping that streak going. I'm just trying to find different ways or better ways to win. You know, like trying to get better in our offense and defense. You know, and it's like basically just keeping that competitive mindset. You know, keeping that competitive flow going.
Meanwhile, Northwestern's season came to an end on Thursday in the Big Ten Tournament thanks to a record performance by Iowa. The Hawkeyes broke the tournament record for points, field goals, and three-pointers in a 112-76 win over the Wildcats in Indy. The blowout brings an end to another disappointing season for Northwestern. Despite being competitive in a couple of conference games, the Wildcats only came up with 7 Big Ten victories and finished 15-16. Some are even wondering if head coach Chris Collins may be on the hot seat after 5 straight years without a postseason appearance. DePaul's season also came to an end in their conference tournament, most likely their elimination on Wednesday against St. John's, 92-73 at Madison Square Garden, has the Blue Demons finishing their first year under Tony Stubblefield with a 15-16 record with a 6-14 mark in the Big East. Meanwhile, Notre Dame is a surprise early exit from the ACC tournament in Brooklyn. The second-seeded Irish were knocked off by 7th-seeded Virginia Tech on Thursday night. Mike Bray's team is projected to make the tournament, though they could be in the double-digit seed range. Meanwhile, Loyola is a spectator this weekend, with their ticket to the Big Dance already punched. They won 3 games in Arch Madness in St. Louis to win the Valley Tournament title last weekend, so they're off to the NCAA Tournament for a 3rd time in 5 years, and projections have them around a 10-11 seed. But the expectations are high for these Ramblers. The last 2 times they went dancing, they made deep runs into the tournament. So senior Marquise Kennedy will not settle for a one and done in 2022.
100%, like we're a team that we know like can win it all, like the whole thing. And we have a bunch of winners on our team. That's all we want. That's all we want to do is win.
We've got an experienced group that understands and knows that, you know, however the feeling felt on Sunday, you know, after Arch Madness winning that, the feeling can get so much better. And so that's what we want to chase. We want to be really good this week about doing everything we got to do to prepare to get better.
On the women's side, a few teams are on the tournament bubble locally. Northwestern is 17-12 with an 8-8 Big Ten record, but ESPN has them as the last team out in the tournament projections. The same goes for DePaul in those rankings of the first 4 out. With a 22-10 record, they are on the bubble with a 14-6 mark in the Big East. We'll see what happens with the Blue Demons. Notre Dame will be in after finishing 22-8 with an overall record, including 12-5 at the ACC. They are slated to be around a 5th seed. Now, on the women's tournament side, there is one local team that's looking to punch their ticket to the big dance. Well, more Southern Illinois. That is the Southern Illinois Salukis. The regular season champions in the Valley begin their conference tournament on Friday. They'll face Indiana State in Moline at noon. We talked last week about Chicago State and the building of their program. Well, they made it to the WAC tournament, but were eliminated quickly. First round by Utah Valley earlier this week. Now, this week's Crash Course features a team headed to the big dance, but not in the NCAA, but rather the National Junior College Athletic Association. Triton College is there for the first time at the Division I level of the sport, though they had to wait a bit to hear their name on the selection show.
The last two teams to fill out in our bracket, an at-large selection. Triton, the Trojans, number 11 seed.
The Trojans indeed were the 23rd of 24 teams announced during the Division I selections, but the wait was worth it for the program. After winning the Division II national title in 2018, they fell just short of a tournament three straight seasons at Division I. This year, however, their 27-5 record was good enough for an at-large bid in the 11th seed. They'll face Caldwell Tech in the first round on March 15th in Hutchinson, Kansas, and forward Patrick Sumnick, who is headed to West Virginia next year, along with first-year head coach John Clancy, cannot wait for the moment.
Last ride with my brothers, with what we built this season on what is either the best team or one of the best teams that any of us have ever played on. Just being able to have one last go around and keep continuing to share the ball and play for each other and do all those things. Like, it's great to be a part of that, and just being able to do that with them in the tournament, in the big dance, that's what I'm really looking forward to with us.
And I want them to realize what they've achieved is a great honor, and really to go out and play with joy for one another, play with great energy and enthusiasm like they've had. We're kind of playing with house money at this point, so let's go out and let's try to be our best and be the most together team we can.
Good luck to Triton. Now, tonight's extra credit is a salute to a basketball coach who is well-known here in Illinois, who saw his tenure end in Manhattan, Kansas this week. Bruce Weber resigned as head coach of Kansas State on Thursday, doing so after 10 years with that program, and helping the Wildcats to two Big 12 titles and five NCAA appearances and the Elite Eight in 2018, where they lost to Loyola. Now, if Weber does decide to step away from coaching, he left quite a legacy here in the state of Illinois, leading Illinois to a pair of outright Big Ten titles in 2004 and 2005. The last of those seasons, perhaps the most celebrated in school history, as Illinois won 37 games and advanced to what so far is their only national championship game. In 5 years at Southern Illinois, Weber built the Salukis into one of the Missouri Valley Conference's best teams. He brought a pair of Valley titles to Carbondale and two NCAA tournaments, including a memorable run to the Sweet 16 in 2002 that ultimately would help him get the Illinois job and make a lot of memories in Champaign, delivering one of the greatest seasons in the history of Illini basketball. Bruce will not be forgotten in Champaign or in Carbondale if he does indeed decide to step away from coaching after his tenure at Kansas State has come to an end. That'll do it for this edition of Campus Check-In. Now, I want to make sure that you are checking WGN News Now on WGNTV.com as we continue to have updates on NCAA tournament teams that do advance or even those that decide to go to the NIT or maybe even the CBI. We'll have them covered here on this program and on the web. But for now, I'm Larry Hawley. Have a wonderful day and enjoy watching the tournaments and Selection Sunday.